Silk has always had very important space in the life of mankind. A historical trade route beginning from China, reaching to European land, across Anatolia and Mediterranean is the Silk Road. After the establishment of Anatolian Seljuk state in Anatolia in the 12th century, Seljuk sultans placed special importance on the development of trade and had a lot of caravanserai built. One of the last caravanserais of Anatolian Seljuk state in the west is this Akhan caravanserai, which we are visiting now. As you see, this built Akhan caravanserai was built 758 years ago and is one of the last caravanserais of Anatolian Seljuks. Akhan is a typical Seljuk caravanserai of the 13th century. It is written on the tablet that you see at the top of the door that this caravanserai was built by the governor of province Seyfettin Karasungur bin Abdullah in 1253 to 1254 during Second İzzettin Keykavus period. Akhan has two portals, main portal and inner portal. Portals has geometric, floral and figural ornamentations placed mostly on the portals. The ornamentations of the main portal are more elaborate than those on the portal of the shelter. Especially the figural presentations of the main portal make Akhan remarkable among the Seljuk caravanserais. These figures are mostly animal figures, but also a few human figures are evident. The figures on the west side of the door are symmetrical. These images are the figures in Asian style 12 animal turkey cylinder. Akhan has two principal parts, courtyard and shelter. This caravanserai was located on a 1,100 meter square field. It has a square courtyard and a rectangular hall. While the stones, which didn't need delicate workmanship, were used in some parts of the masterwork Akhan, south and west side of the court is covered with original smooth marble. Some reused ornamented blocks were used on the caravanserai for a purpose of decoration, such as a Medusa head, consoles on the A1. On the portal, we see another tablet. It is written here that shelter section was completed in 1253 by the governor of that time. As you see, there are three naves in the shelter. The naves in both sides were used as stable. Now, I will explain how a caravan was made up in medieval times and how Akhan caravanserai served. Caravans were often established in significant trade centers such as port cities. The one who conducted caravan was called caravan master. Caravan master would buy animals to carry goods. Those animals were resistant to traveling over long distances. Caravan master would choose security guards who could move along with the caravan and ensure safety. And also, a guide would be taken into the caravan. Guide was truly important because at that time, different languages were spoken in Anatolia and merchants and caravan passengers were from different nations. When preparations were completed, they would make farewells to their families. Constructed with 30 to 40 kilometer long intervals, 9-hour camel walking distance, caravanserais were places in which passengers could safely stay. Anatolian Seljuk state attached great importance to trade. Caravanserais where passengers could safely stay, free up to 3 days, and meet accommodation and food needs were constructed by sultans, governors, and the important statesmen themselves. When caravaners went inside, they would unload their load in the open shelter part. Registration and counting of goods taken from animals was a must, because in case of decreasing goods, loss had to be compensated by state, much like today's insurance system. Animals which came from a long distance would be brought to stable and fed. Veterinarian of caravanserai would take care of animals free of charge. Their damaged horseshoes would be replaced. During their long trips, passengers would become sick or injured. And in Akhan Caravanserai, there was a hospital for them. Here, drugs were made from herbs. Also, treatment of passengers were done by doctors for free. Caravanserais were not only a place for accommodation. Tradesmen could trade in city bazaar. When the sun went down, the gates would be closed. After it was closed, nobody would be able to go in and out. Towards the evening, dinner preparations would begin. meal was cooked in stone ovens. For caravaners and caravanserai workers, meat, bread and water would be served. In addition, region special meals would be prepared. A large table would be set up in courtyard and everyone was invited. Everybody, Muslim or non-Muslim, free or slave, without any discrimination, would eat at the same table. After dinner, passengers would chat and sing songs. Even some of them would play songs of their own region with instruments. Thus, people from different cultures would come together. In the morning, when they were leaving Caravanserai, passengers would be woken up with tramways, and they were farewelled with a ceremony.
Ey ümmeti Muhammed, malınız, atınız, canınız tam mı?
Hepsi tamamdır. Cenab-ı Hak hayır sahibine rahmet eyle.
Yollarda gafil gafil gitmeyin. Vakit kaybetmeyin. Herkesi arkadaş etmeyin. Yürüyün, Allah kolaylık getirir.